No ambush campaigns. No intentions of increasing the number of channels. No grand marketing campaigns. DTH service provider Tata Sky has launched a premium range of set-top boxes which will be called Tata Sky Plus in the latest move on the DTH battlefield. This set-top box, the first of its kind in India, comes with an inbuilt personal video recorder, also called PVR, which means that you can pause a movie you may be watching and catch it from exactly where you left it. You can rewind that movie too if you need to watch a few of those scenes again. Record the movie and the sitcom if they're happening simultaneously for up to 45 hours. But all this comes at a price of 9,000 rupees for the set-top box. Compare this to the regular set-top box that comes with a price tag of 1,500 rupees.
The value proposition will come out of how much you value the fact that you're going to change the way you watch television and set the home free.
The price may be an obstacle in a market where 80% of television households are still cable television viewers. Existing subscribers will also have to pay for the new box, though they will be given a concession. But Tata officials are confidently looking at an 8 million subscriber base by 2012.
Tata Sky went to 2 million in 20 months, which is a world record of sorts. So there's clearly a transformation that's happening in the category. And I believe that we must not always reduce everything down to the lowest common denominator.
Rivals are already working out competing strategies. Big TV is soon to double its channel offering from 200 to 400 channels. Dish TV is planning to speed up the establishment of their dish service stations, and Airtel is also looking to launch its own PVRs. The DTH players are putting all their cards on the table. But are the subscribers biting the bait? Pratiksha Menon, UTVI, Mumbai.